Hello guys, Dan here. Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to show you how to paint the rest of the Nomad side of the Operation Crimson Stone. So all the four of the rest guys, they can be painted using the same techniques that I'm going to show you in this video. You don't actually need that many colors for this because they're just red and black. Following this tutorial, you can paint all of them without any problems. So without further ado, sit back, relax, and let's do it. All the models were primed with the black primer, and then I proceed applying the first color, and that's going to be red. So I'm going to use a burn red, and I'm going to apply it in two very thin coats on the all areas on the models that are going to be black. So there'll be two different materials that we need to cover with this color, which is actually the clothing items like the pants and the metal items, which will be all the armor panels. So we will start for all of them from the burnt red. So just go carefully around the model and just paint these areas with the two very thin coats, and you will have a really decent coverage with this color. After I'm done with that, I'm just going now to paint only the metal armor panels, and I want them to be much brighter red than the cloth. So I'm going to use Evil Sun Scarlet, and this time only one thin coat will be enough, and I'm going to repaint all those armor panels in the scarlet red. After that, I'm going to move on and start blocking colors on the rest of the armor panels. First ones that I'm going to do is going to be the ones that I want them to be white. So I'm going to pick up pale blue, and I'm just going to paint these panels. This is painted with two very thin coats of this color, but wait for the first coat to completely dry before applying a second one, so that you have a really good coverage of this paint. If you still try to paint it while the paint is wet, you just keep moving pigments all around and you won't achieve a good effect. As you can see, I already painted the weapons of these guys. If you're interested how I did it in my last video, so I will include the card just above the model there in the right corner, and also in the link section down below. So if you're interested, you can go and check out that video. So let's move on now, and I use a neutral gray to paint some of the armor panels that I wanted to be gray. And just to put a little diversity in the black. And I also painted most of the jetpack with this color. As you can see, the first layer is not covering actually that much, but I waited it for completely to dry, and then I went over with the second layer, and then I had a really nice coverage of this color. Now, since we blocked all our base colors of the model, I'm going to start shading the model. For all the red parts, so both bright red and dark red, I'm going to use Druki Violet, and I'm going to apply one like medium thickness coat of the wash. So just go around and just pull all the wash into the recesses, and you can remove all the excess that's on top of the flat armor panels, because we are going to repaint them anyway, but you want your wash to be inside the recesses to create shadows on the model. And then for everything else that is left, we are going to use Noon Oil and just cover everything else. I didn't mention that I'm using these shades straight from the pot, applying them directly on the models. And before proceeding to the highlight stage, I'm going to leave models now for 25 minutes to half an hour for wash to dry properly. Since wash really darkened the burnt thread, I'm going to pick up it again, and I'm just going to repaint the pants. But this time I'm going to leave all the recesses dark. So I'm going to be focused mostly on areas that are raised, like this little pocket pouches that she have, and like all the folds that you can see on the pants, just highlight the top part of those folds. After that, I'm going to mix a little of the sunny skin tone into burnt red, and that's going to create my highlight color. And this time I'm going to be focused only on the raised area of the folds and on the stitches and the edges of the pockets. And I'm going to finish highlighting the pants with this. And I'm going to do the totally same thing with the Evil Sun Scarlet and the Metal Armor Plates. So first I'm going to repaint them with the Scarlet Red, but leaving all the recesses and the shades created by the wash intact. And the same as in the previous step, I'm going to add a little of the sunny skin tone into the Evil Sun Scarlet, and then I'm going to start highlighting the model. But this time, since we are working with the metal armor panels, we are going to be focused on the edge, highlighting it. So you're going to use your small brush, and you're going to trace all the edges. At this stage, these lines doesn't need to be a super thin, but you don't want to cover most of the previous work with this color. Also, you're going to be focused on the areas that are in the top of the model that are mostly exposed from the light that are coming up from above, and you're going to put a little more highlight there. For the final edge highlight, I'm going to use ivory, and I'm going to mix a little of it in the mix that I made before with the sunny skin tone in Evil Sun Scarlet. So this is going to create even a brighter pinkish red. And this is going to be our final highlight, and this is actually to be the thinnest possible lines that you can do on the edges. So you're going to be focused only on the edges with this highlight. Now we are going to move on to finish off the rest of the armor panels. Next ones in line are actually the one that I wanted them to be white. So I'm going to go back and pick up a pale blue, and I'm just going to repaint them to return them to their natural state before the wash. And then I'm going to pick up white, and I'm going to start adding white to the pale blue. I will start with 50-50 mix and then keep adding more to start highlighting these armor panels. And then for the final stage, I'm going to use pure white and just do the edge highlights on these armor panels. There is not that many areas that you need to do with this, so it is going to go really fast and easy. After that, we are going to do the same thing with the gray armor panels. So I'm going to go back to a neutral gray, and I'm just going to repaint those panels with this color, because the shade really left some marks there. So I'm going to return them to their previous state. And I will try to avoid going inside the recesses. So this is just going to be a really small fix, just to return everything in the previous state before start highlights. For the final highlight on all of these gray parts, I used pure white, and I just traced all the edges with this color. So I went just really carefully around the model, and I just tried to highlight every edge, because this is going to bring the final look to the model, so be patient and just go around and do this. And the last thing that we need to do is actually to highlight everything that is left black. We have two types of the materials here. So we have a black leather, which is on the clothing items, like on the boots. And we have a black metal, which will be on the armor panels and on the weapons. The thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to pick up a black and white, and I'm just going to mix a little of white into the black that I create some darker gray color. And I'm going to highlight the whole model with this. So both metal and the clothing, actually leather items on this model, is going to be highlighted with this color. So I'm just going to trace all the edges, all the stitches. When you come to the weapons on the armor panels, you're going to trace all the sharpest edges of those panels. And the final and the last thing that we need to do is to highlight the black metal parts, which includes the gun and the armor panels. So for this you're going to use pure white and just highlight it with very thin lines. Just a note here, you won't do any highlights on the black leather that we already did. We will leave it as it is so that it have one shade darker tone than the rest of the black parts. And that will be all for this video, guys. This will wrap up Operation Crimson Stone. So I actually painted the whole box. I will include the link for the rest of the models here in the little card. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. It will mean a lot to me and it will help this channel grow. And if you have any comments or suggestions, please leave them in the section down below and I will try to do my best to reply. This will be all for now, guys. Stay safe, take care, and see you around. Bye bye.